Congratulations on graduating, Hannah. I tried to go to college once. Not even graduate school, mind you, just college. But before I could even make it to any of my classes, well, I didn't get too far, because when I was trying to purchase my books in the bookstore on campus, see that the textbooks were just so heavy, and so I accidentally dropped them on my foot, which of course really hurt and made me sprain my ankle, and because I was hopping around from how much that hurt, well then I accidentally ran into a bookshelf, and then that bookshelf knocked into another bookshelf, which then took down all the other bookshelves, and well, before I knew it, I just ruined the whole store, and it was just such a disaster, and so before I was even able to start any of my classes, well, the school kinda kicked me out. Well, but you! Look at you! Made it all the way through college and now graduate school! I am, for one, am just truly impressed by that, and I'm so proud of you!
Salutations, Hannah! Surely you remember me, Professor Willis Whitehead, PhD? Well, from one postgraduate academic to another, I would like to extend my sincere congratulations. I truly believe that academic pursuit is one of the noblest endeavors one can embark upon. And today, we celebrate this most commendable and honorable milestone of your academic achievement regarding such matters. For strength of the body and the glowing aesthetic of youth will fade over time, but might and fortitude of the mind, well, that is something that will last a lifetime. Now, where did I put my glasses?
Ahoy, Hannah, and congratulations on such a wonderful achievement. As a strong and powerful woman myself, I recognize the courageous seafaring spirit needed to carry a person through the impressive waters of a graduate school voyage. Life isn't always smooth sailing, but you've shown that through hard work, dedication, and commitment, you can achieve excellence and you can steer your ship to just about any destination you dream of reaching. I'm proud of you. And your capstone presentation was great. You were so poised, professional, and you really looked like you had it all put together. Unlike some other people in this family.
Can't seem to find them.
And oops, sorry. Well, I just got so excited because I've been anxious to tell you that, well, because of all the rotations you've been doing with the student athletes, and of course, in honor of our dear cousin LaQuatro, well, I myself have been inspired to try to improve my own athletic abilities. So, I thought I'd take it upon myself to try to learn a few sports and see how I could do. So, the first sport that I tried to do was football.
Now, Kletzy, you see, this is a football, a double-sided conical object that when you throw it, soars through the air like a projected missile. You see, as the football is sailing through the air, it is rotating like a gyrometer, which keeps it steady and clean. Now, Kletzy, here's how you catch a football. When I throw it through the air, you have your eye on it, and as it comes into you, you gather it in with both arms to secure it to your body, okay? All right.
Okay.
Let's try it out then, okay?
Okay.
Here goes.
Ooh.
Excuse me, but I wasn't done yet. Jeez.
I also wanted to say, Hannah, that I really appreciated the topic you chose for your capstone. Mental health is so important, especially for those young college athletes who have so many things going on in their lives. One aspect of mental health that I think is so important in these athletes, or really in anyone, is making sure that their confidence and self-esteem is looked after so they can be successful on and off the field. Really, taking care of and contributing positively to a young person's self-esteem is paramount to a healthy development.
Gosh, what is the matter with you, Klutzy? I can't believe it. You are such a nincompoop. Can you not do anything right? Ugh.
But, well, football didn't really go so well. So the next sport I tried to do was basketball.
As you notice, the basketball is a spherical object, like the Earth and other planets. That allows it to bounce up and down, like so. And when we move the basketball around the court, as you see, we do it by what is called dribbling, which means bouncing it up and down with one hand. Now, you try it, Klutzy.
Okay. I just can't get it. I just can't do it right. It's so hard.
Let's see. Watch how it's done. Watch. Okay, Klutzy, now it's your turn to try to make a basket. Just go and throw it up there and make it go through the hoop.
Okay, here I go.
Dribble, dribble. Oh, there we go. Oh, dear.
Intervention is also a very important part of mental health. If you see that a member of your crew is struggling, it's imperative to step in and do what you can to provide help, to offer positive support and intervention.
For heaven's sakes! Why is this such a struggle for you, Klutzy? Pick yourself up, dust yourself off, and let's buck up! Nincompoops, you helpless swabbies!
Oh. Basketball didn't really end up working out so well either. So, finally, I thought, well, maybe I'll try to learn how to play soccer. I mean, how hard can that be? I mean, all you have to do is kick a ball, right?
This is a soccer ball, also a spherical object. Now, let's put it on the ground because we control it with our feet instead of our hands. So, unlike basketball, which is when we dribble the ball, in soccer we also dribble the ball with our feet. So, this is how you move it around on the field, see? Okay, Klutzy, why don't you try it?
Okay.
Oh, dear.
Anyway, in summation, I just wanted to say that I think it's great you highlighted the necessity and relevance of mental health as a focus in college sports, because these student athletes, much like a crew on a ship, need to know that people care about them, not only for the job they're doing on the field or on the deck, but for who they are always as human beings.
Good grief! I can't even watch this anymore. Klutzy, you are just hopeless. Helpless. You shouldn't do any athletics. I don't even know how you manage to walk around as a functional human being. I'm done with you.
So, anyway, well, soccer really didn't work out, and by that point I just had to stop because I was really getting very hurt by that point. So, anyway, I came to the conclusion that I just don't think I'll ever be the kind of athlete that you are, and certainly not the kind of athlete that LaQuatro is. But anyway, there is a bright side to all this, because I know, having recently graduated, well, you're probably looking for a job right now. And so, the good news is that I'm now in the need, after all my adventures and attempts at athletics, I'm really in a need of a good athletic trainer who knows what they're doing, who can help treat me for all my sports injuries and help rehabilitate me. So, anyway, I would personally like to offer to be your very first client, because boy, I really need help.
Hannah, From all of us, congratulations. And now, a performance of Pomp and Circumstance, composed by Sir Edward Elgar. We will perform this in the key of C major.
Okay, selected members of the Carolyn Cauliflowers, Pomp and Circumstance.